Scotland?
Yay!
Who's come from Wales?
Woo!
Who's come from another place that's quite far away?
Woo!
Thank you very much. Now, I made a speech last time, so that was quite long, and I'm not going to repeat myself. But I just wanted to say thank you to all the new listeners who've discovered us. In the strategy plan, the claim was made that only 1 in 20 of the UK population had heard of Six Music. Well, there are now over a million of us.
Woo!
Moving in the right direction, as DJs say. I think there are more, actually, and let me tell you why without boring the pants off you. The audience research is conducted by people being given a radar diary to fill in once a quarter. Has anybody ever had a radar diary?
No!
Well, a man came walking up to my garden last summer and gave me a radar diary over the wall. And I thought, well, I can fill it in. I'll pay my licence fee. But interestingly enough, the radio stations that were listed were Radio 1, Radio 2, 3, 4, 5. Was Six Music on the list?
No!
What did you have to do, I asked as I ran after him with my biro down the street. Oh, you just have to write Six Music on yourself if you listen to it. So I suspect that there are a lot more than a million people listening. What do you think?
Yeah.
Also, my son who was hanging about there in his pyjamas at 3 o'clock in the afternoon about to go off to university was offered a £300 prize if he filled in the radar because not enough young people fill it in. So I think if you added on all the 15 to 24 year olds that don't fill it in and all the under 15s, we'd have a lot more listeners, maybe 1.5 million, maybe 2 million. So I think, well done, 1,200,000 of us, but I think this radio station has got a huge audience that cannot be ignored anymore. Recently, we've had a general election, and what did the party say before that general election? Well, I don't want to say which party I voted for, but the Conservatives said, let's cap the licence fee, let's pare down the BBC, let's introduce our own management in there to watch over the executive, and let's scrap the BBC Trust. Trust work for us, the listeners. They're there to protect our interests, to make sure that us licence payers get what we pay for and what we want. So, how many people have written to the BBC Trust?
Yeah.
Our message today, Sir Michael Lyons, under political pressure from a new government, is do not cave in, be true to democracy, be true to what people have told you, and save Six Music.
Yeah.
What a huge cultural influence and export the music of this country is. And the new Chancellor stood up the other day and he talked about wisely exploiting new emerging markets in the Far East, like China, the new middle classes with money to spend. And he said the future of this country depends on us churning out goods for those new people with money in their pockets. And he mentioned, I think, cars, he mentioned pharmaceuticals, even mentioned television programmes. Yes, we can sell all that, but I've never been abroad. I've never found myself in the African bush where somebody said to me, oh, madam, I really welcome Smith, Glaxon, Klein, Beecham. No, they said, oh, do you know about the Beatles? Do you know about Coldplay? Do you know about the Zootons and lots of other bands? It's music that takes our language and our culture around the world, and we should capitalise on that as a country and make sure that we export our culture around the world. And part of that, because we get emails all the time from people listening abroad, is Six Music getting out there right around the world. It's not just us, it's the whole world. Thank you for listening. I would like to introduce you to somebody now. As I said, there's been a general election underway. The only party that was specific before that election in their manifesto and in their official statement to their MPs was the Liberal Democrat Party, and they said Six Music was distinctive, it was quality, it had reached an audience, and it should be preserved. Now, I don't know what's going to happen now under this new coalition. I've looked at the 70-page coalition document between the Conservatives and the Tories, the new government, and it says that the BBC must be looked after, basically, but it doesn't specifically mention Six Music. But I'd like to introduce you to a man now who's been untroubled by democracy for the last few months. I don't know what you think of the House of Lords, but I can tell you that I've recently discovered there are some very, very earnest, concerned and professional people in there who make it their business to know about the media in this country, to know about the new digital age, and to protect Six Music. I want to welcome back now somebody who took the trouble to come along last time and speak to us when MPs were not available. Fair enough, Saturdays are in the constituency. He knows all about the licensing laws as well, the music licensing laws. He knows why we can't have all the bands on today that offered to come down and play for us. Like the Specials, like the Magic Numbers. We're still hoping to get Eliza Carthy, but please give a big Six Music welcome to our supporter in the House of Lords, the Liberal Democrat peer, Lord Clement Jones.